The next morning, a couple of representatives from the Transportation Management Safety Team, TMST, showed up to investigate the fire. The charred villain fly was quickly surrounded with bright yellow puffs. Riker, a strict aircraft rescue fire vehicle with a very serious expression, arrived with an uptight looking forklift. They eyed Mayday as the gang stood by, concerned. TMST? Chug asked. This means serious trouble, said Sparky. Donnie sighed. Transportation Management Safety Team. The TMST vehicles scattered orange safety cones around the area and then approached Mayday to assess the fire. The forklift even put safety cones around poor Mayday. Then he harshly clicked his pin and began furiously writing on his note. Riker asked an uneasy Mayday a bunch of questions while the forklift took notes. Is that guy writing down everything I say? Mayday asked nervously. Yes, said Riker. Well, So he just wrote that down? Asked Mayday. Yes. And that? Yes. And that? Yes. Riker, getting frustrated. Can you provide me with some self-inspection records and your emergency procedure plans? Mayday chuckled timidly and explained that Hogwash Junction didn't have any emergencies. Ryder did not like that answer. Or when Mayday added, besides, we did get the fire out. Is that your contingency plan, Mr. Mayday? Ryder asked in a monotone voice. Every time there's an incident, you topple over a water tower? He was clearly not last night, because I was going to sound savage trail. Mayday looked at his friend with understanding and whispered, Dusty, it was an accident. But Riker did not want to hear anymore. It's clear that this airport has no plans for an emergency, and its equipment was from last century. So unless Mr. Mayday gets refurbished and acquires a second firefighting vehicle, in accordance with the CFR, Title 14, Volume 3, Chapter 1, Section 139, Subparagraph B, I'm pulling this airport certificate of operation for non-compliance of rescue and firefighting regulations. The forklift clicked his pen closed and tucked it away. Then he and Riker took off, leaving everything in his shop. No one could believe it. Shutting down the airport means shutting down the whole town. Without an active runway, no one could land. Everyone in Plotwash gathered around the main terminal to discuss the terrible news. They immediately started learning about the Corn Festival. Was there even a Corn Festival this year? If the town was closed, they had to cancel. This was a disaster. Skipper tried to get everyone to calm down. He and Dottie had a plan. This is Mayday now, said Dottie as Sparky held up a drawing of Mayday. I did the drawings, Chuck said proudly. We add a new 400-watt siren, a 200 GPM roof turret, a high-capacity water tank with integrated Class A foam cells. Sparky dramatically switched the picture to a new one of Mayday. This showed what he would look like after all the upgrades. Mayday looked ferocious and totally cool. And we have a whole new Mayday. The crowd started to tip in. Maybe they could save the popcorn? Get out! He gets rocket boosters, Sparky admitted. Admired the picture in awe. Fueled by good old hydrazine and nitrogen peroxide. Of course, that stuff's highly explosive, so you didn't want to get it around no point, Bub said. But he's a fire cop, said Sparky. Duh, go on, Dottie. Dottie explained that once Mayday was up, all they would need to reopen Pup Watch was a second fire. Again, panic set in along the crowd. Popwash didn't have the money to pay for another firefighter, and on top of that, it's fire season. They wouldn't be able to get a volunteer at this point. It seemed like a hopeless situation. Mayday sadly rolled toward his fire station. With the sun setting on the horizon, he adjusted his crooked fire station. First time since he found out about